Tara Thorson from yogaequanimity.com, and we're back for day five of our 100-day challenge, celebrating the life of BKS Iyengar. Today we have Paschimottanasana as our pose. So Paschimottanasana translates to stretch to the west, so it's the back side of the body that's getting the length, which in my mind then, if you have one side that's opening, you have to have one side that's closing in order to secure the side that's opening. Otherwise, we'll have hyperextension or hypermobilization, which leaves us prone to tears. So let's take a look at Paschimottanasana. The feet and the legs will be coming into Dandasana. You are welcome to sit on a support if you find that the pelvis or the lower back or the knees are bent. You know, if things are tight, then obviously take support, take what you need. I found using support continuously as well as pulling the buttocks back did damage to my ligaments. So now what I do is sit to the floor so that I have a solid surface to bring the legs against. And rather than bring the buttocks back, I would bring them outwards. And as you bring them outwards, or as I bring mine outwards, I find the sacrum then is able to drop evenly in between. And that helps me. Hopefully it'll help you too. So feet towards the floor. Traditionally, your feet are together in Paschimottanasana. We begin from Dandasana. The shoulders back and down, and the shoulders are over the hips the best possible. Spine lengthening up. We can bring the hands forward, hook the thumbs, raise the arms up. Exhale, come forward and take the feet. And this is where the back body really begins to have its extension. So you're pressing the heels down, lengthening the two sides of the trunk up, and you're watching now that the front of the thighs are moving towards the abdomen to engage that front spine, to support the back. And then with an exhalation, you use the arms to pull the trunk forward. So you're really latching the arms into the base of the ribs to bring that region that would want to resist and roll back towards the feet, towards the thighs. And today I'm not going far. So I would take support. And that's another thing. Every single day your practice is going to be different. So that can be discouraging, but it's also pretty charming in the sense that it gives us a job. Because without a job, without complexity, we have no reason to try. And without a reason to try, most of us won't. So here's our try. So you can put support down on top of your legs. And then again, start with that action of lengthening through the front body to secure the back body. And then exhale, coming forward. Then you can pose the forehead onto the bolster. And sometimes it's nice to move into that bad habit, arch it all out, and then use the front body again, the opposite side, to correct it. To come back up, you can again hook the thumbs, lengthen, come back out and up, and sit in your Dandasana. So other variations include keeping the feet wider, and that helps to relax the abdomen. So if you're having trouble like today, that might have been an easier variation for me to come down with the legs wide because it brings me in towards it. You can put a brick in between to rest the forehead onto the brick into the calves, or a brick into the thighs to push through the sternum and get that front body again engaged to the back body. You can take a belt, the rope wall. You know, he was very clever in his practice. The curiosity, the inquiry of the human body and mind were the conditions that made him such an extraordinary man. So celebrating his life for 100 days is certainly not a problem for me. Join us if you want, and post or like or what have you. But we need a celebration, so go for it. And thank you very much. And thanks, Pamela, for inviting me. Talk to you soon.